Hello students, welcome to AIIMS Today YouTube channel. So we are going through AIIMS India live sessions. We have started from chemistry with the chapter chemical reactions and equations. So from few days onwards we are learning about this chapter chemical reactions and equations. We have seen what are chemical reactions, what are chemical equations, how to balance them, what are different kinds of chemical reactions, what are different types of reactions we have learned, like combination reactions, decomposition reactions, displacement reactions, double displacement reactions, and even recently we have seen about redox reactions also. So based upon these all concepts, let us have a small assessment, means what we have studied, what we have learned in the previous sessions, what we understood from the previous sessions. So those are we are going to assess in this session. So we are going to have simple questions on these topics. So let us try those. So get ready for the assessments. Let's go here with the first question. Which of the following is a chemical change? It's a simple question you have started. Let us see options given. Boiling of water to give water vapor. Melting of ice to give water. Dissolution of salt in water. Combustion of liquefied petroleum gas, which is simply called LPG. See, out of these changes, which comes under chemical change? This simple question. If you know answer, you can give in the live chat. We can see here who are giving answers. We can check it. Yes, it is just assessment for us. What we have learned, what we have understood, what we don't know still. So these all we can assess ourselves by attempting these answers. So we can attempt answer by giving your answer in the live chat. Then we can check it. Yes, we are trying well. Some of you are giving correct answer. Yes, what is chemical change? The change in which a new substance is formed. The original substance is converted into new form. That is called chemical change. You see, boiling of water gives water vapor. In this, water changes into water vapor. But before and after the reaction, there is no chemical composition change. Always will be in the even the water or water vapor form, it is H2O only. So there is no change in the chemical composition, so it is not a physical, it is just a physical change, not chemical change. We say ice converting into water, this also comes under only physical change, because the molecular formula will be same in these states also. Even it is water or ice, the formula will be same. Only change is there in the arrangement of molecules, but from one state to another state, change occurring. Dissolution of salt into water. What happens? A physical mixture occurs by the dissolution of salt into water. No change in the chemical composition. Salt formula, salt will be salt only, water will be water only. Chemical composition not going to be changed. But when you combust this liquefied petroleum gas, LPG is undergone combustion. LPG is made up of certain hydrocarbons called butane and diesel. When it is undergone combustion, it burns in the presence of oxygen, finally it forms carbon dioxide and water vapor. So new substances are formed. The change in which new substance formed is called chemical change. So out of these four, which is a chemical change? Yes, many of you have given correct answer. Good. It is D. D is correct answer. Next, let us go to next question. Reduction is gain of. We studied about oxidation and reduction reactions in the earlier class. What is meant by oxidation? This oxidation and reduction can be defined in different terms. One in terms of oxygen, other than hydrogen, in terms of electron, in terms of oxidation number also. So if you say in terms of oxygen, gain of oxygen is oxidation. Loss of oxygen is reduction. If we say in terms of hydrogen, gain of hydrogens is reduction, loss of hydrogens is oxidation. If you say in terms of electrons, gain of electrons is reduction, loss of electrons is oxidation. One more it is there, in terms of oxidation number, gain of the increase in the oxidation number is called oxidation, the decrease in the oxidation number is called reduction. So there are different terminology given to explain oxidation and reduction. Now they are asking reduction is, let us see options so that you can understand. Reduction is gain of electrons, is it gain of protons, is it gain of neutrons or oxygens? Which is correct answer? Can you give your answer in the live chat? Reduction is gain of electrons. Yes, it is correct. Gain of electrons is reduction. Gain of oxygens is oxidation. So, in terms of electrons we have seen. In terms of oxygen also we have obtained definitions for the oxidation and reduction. So, if in terms of electrons, gain of electrons is reduction, loss of electrons is oxidation. If you say in terms of oxygens, gain of oxygens is oxidation, loss of oxygens is reduction. Now, in terms, they are telling gain of. So, gain of means oxygens, sorry, electrons. Electrons gain is reduction. That is the correct answer. Good. Next one. Let's go to third question. Gain of oxygen is, just now we have seen, in terms of oxygen, oxidation and reduction can be explained. The gain of oxygen is known as, let us see options, is it oxidation or reduction, is it halogenation or chlorination? What it is called? Gain of oxygen is called, yes, any try? Yes, good. It is oxidation. Gain of oxygen is called oxidation. Next question. Decrease in oxidation number is called. In terms of oxidation number, oxidation and reduction both are explained. So, here in terms of oxidation number, the decrease in the oxidation number is called as what? Is it oxidation or reduction? Or halogenation and chlorination is given. So, about these two, we have to discuss here. What it is called? Whether oxidation or reduction? The decrease in the oxidation number. Yes? The decrease in the oxidation number is called? Yes, many of you trying. Good. Yes? Yeah. It is reduction. Decrease in the oxidation number is called reduction. Increase in the oxidation number is called oxidation. Now, they asked about decrease in the oxidation number. So, reduction is correct answer. Next. So, here is one more question. The reaction in which oxidation and reduction takes place at the same time or simultaneously is called. Yes, the chemical reactions in which oxidation and reduction both occur simultaneously are known as, what are they called? Redox reaction, oxidation reaction, reduction reaction, none of these. So, what is correct answer? The chemical reactions are the reactions in which oxidation and reduction both occur simultaneously are known as. Yes, anyone trying here? Okay. Yes, they are called redox reactions. The following reaction is an example of. See what kind of reaction it is. Let us see options. Displacement reaction, combination reaction, redox reaction, neutralization reaction. So, from these four, it might be one or more than one suitable statements. Let us check them. What options are given? First, let us come back to this equation once. If it is observed here at the starting of the reaction, nitrogen is in combination with hydrogen, but after the reaction it combined with oxygen. So what we can say, it lost hydrogens and it gained oxygens. So both these two are explained as oxidation, or you can say, if you see in terms of oxygen coming and replacing this hydrogen, or hydrogen is coming off, oxygen replacing hydrogen, what we can say, it is displacement reaction. So oxygen displacing hydrogen and forming nitric oxide. So the place of hydrogen is taken by oxygen, that is hydrogen displaced by oxygen. This kind of reactions we called as displacement reactions. So it is correct answer. Next, so it is not combination, just it is a replacement reaction is going on, so not combination. And redox reaction they have given. What does it mean? Redox reaction means the chemical reaction in which both oxidation and reduction occurring simultaneously are known as redox reactions. So let us see whether oxidation reductions are occurring in this reaction. If you see in terms of ammonia contains hydrogens with nitrogen initially. Nitrogen has hydrogens in combination earlier the reaction, but after reaction it gained oxygens to form nitric oxide. So here this compound losing hydrogens and gaining oxygens. This gaining of oxygens is called oxidation. So ammonia undergone oxidation here. This is undergoing oxidation reaction. If you see in terms of oxygen, initially oxygen is in the elementary form or pure oxygen form. But if you observe after the reaction, here oxygen gained hydrogen and forming water molecule. Oxygen gained hydrogens. So this gaining of hydrogens is called, what do you say? Yes, it is called reduction. Oxygen is reduced. So here reduction reaction is undergoing, taking place. Here oxidation reaction taking place. The chemical reaction in which both oxidation and reduction occurring simultaneously is called redox reaction. Hence it is also coming under redox reaction. Reaction between ammonia and oxygen is a redox reaction. It is a displacement reaction, at the same time redox reaction also. So this also will come under, it is not neutralization reaction, because we know what does it mean by neutralization reaction. A chemical reaction in which a salt and water are formed by the reaction of an acid and base. Here no salt and water formation, hence we say it is not a neutralization reaction. Only these two are correct, first and third. So now let us see where it is. Sorry, it is correct answer. First and third is because in this reaction displacement is going on, at the same time redox reaction is taking place. Both oxidation and reduction are occurring. So third option will be correct answer. Okay, now let us go to next question. Here is the question. Which of the following is true for a balanced chemical equation? So we discussed about balanced chemical equation or chemical equations. A chemical equation, when it is called balanced, when it is said to be unbalanced. So let us see options so that you can understand. Number of various terms is equal on both the sides. Then is it called then balanced equation? Number of various terms is more on left side. Is it correct? Or number of various terms is more on right side, means at the product side. Is it correct? Number of various atoms is unequal on both the sides. Is it correct? So, which statement is correct for explanation of balanced chemical equation? See here, in the first option they have given, number of various atoms is equal on both the sides. Yes, it is correct. Because all the chemical equations should satisfy the law which is called law of conservation of mass. As per law of conservation of mass, the total mass before the chemical reaction should be equal to the total mass formed after the chemical reaction. Means the total mass of the reactants and product should be equal always in any chemical reaction. This is explained by law of conservation of mass. To be equal, so the number of atoms which are participating in the chemical reaction should be equal to the total number of atoms formed after the chemical reaction. So that is said in the first option here. Number of atoms of various elements, or number of various atoms, or the atoms of various elements should be equal on the both the sides of the chemical reaction. So A is a correct answer. Now let us go to the next question. In which of the following category will you put the reaction of heating of calcium carbonate? You know, calcium carbonate heating, what will happen? Let us see options here. Deposition of calcium, deposition reaction, is it? Decomposition reaction, sorry. Calcium carbonate heating will come under decomposition or combination reaction or displacement reaction or double displacement. What kind of reaction it is going on when calcium carbonate is heated? Yes, what happens? When calcium carbonate is heated, it forms calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. One compound splitting into two or more simpler compounds. It is called decomposition reaction. Yes, what answers we are giving? Right? Yes, it is correct. Decomposition reaction is going on there. Because calcium carbonate, we know, when it is heated, it forms calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. So, one compound splitting into two simpler compounds. This is explained in decomposition reactions. So, the decomposition of calcium carbonate is, yes, it is a decomposition reaction. Heating of calcium carbonate is decomposition reaction. Next question. Which of the following is not the correct categorization for the reaction of heating of calcium carbonate? So, on the same question, again, one more statement is given. So, which of the following is not the correct categorization for the reaction of heating of calcium carbonate? So, they might have given this different way here, same reaction. Let us see. Is it a decomposition reaction? Is it a thermal decomposition reaction? Is it endothermic reaction? Is it electrolysis reaction? What kind of reaction is heating of calcium carbonate? In the earlier question, we have seen calcium carbonate CaCO3 on heating gives calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. So this is a reaction which occurs when calcium carbonate is heated. So we said already a compound splitting into two or more simpler compounds. Hence, it comes under decomposition reaction. Yes, it is a decomposition reaction. But let us check the remaining options also. It is given here, thermal decomposition. What does meant by thermal? Thermal means heat related. So here decomposition is occurring because of the heat produced given there. So that is why on the iron bar we have shown here triangular symbol, which represents the heating is happening. So this calcium carbonate is undergone heating. In the question also it is asked the heating of calcium carbonate. So the reactions in which heat is given, those reactions are called thermal reactions. So it is also coming under thermal decomposition reaction. One more, if you observe here, third option, endothermic reaction. What does it mean by endothermic? The chemical reactions in which heat energy is absorbed are called endothermic reactions. Here, in the decomposition of calcium carbonate, heat energy is given. Heat is given in this reaction. So, heat is absorbed for the production of calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Heat is absorbed for the decomposition of calcium carbonate. So, it is an endothermic reaction. The chemical reactions in which energy, heat energy is absorbed are called endothermic reactions. The chemical reactions in which energy, heat energy is given are called exothermic reactions. Here, heat energy is absorbed, so they also come under endothermic reactions. So these three are correct about heating of calcium carbonate. But what about electrolysis? What does it mean by electrolysis? Here, electro represents electricity or current. Lysis means splitting. So the splitting of a chemical compound in the presence of electricity is called electrolysis. But here, calcium carbonate is splitting in the presence of heat energy, not electricity. So it is not coming under electrolysis. It is not an electrolysis reaction. So what will be correct answer, children? Now, yeah, many of you have been already as D is correct answer. Good. So heating of calcium carbonate is not electrolysis. It is a decomposition or thermal decomposition, or also it is said to be endothermic reaction. Right. Next question. Which of the following statements about the given reaction are correct? Let us see once the equation so that we can see later statements. This is a statement given. This equation given here. About that, some statements are given. Iron metal is getting oxidized. Water is getting reduced. Water is acting as reducing agent. Water is acting as oxidizing agent. So, which statements are correct about this equation? Now, let us say about the equation once again. Iron combining with oxygen to form iron oxide and hydrogen. So, what is happening here? Let us see one by one. First, iron is in the free metal form before the reaction. But after the reaction, if you observe, it gained certain oxygen atoms. So, this gaining of oxygen atoms is called oxidation. We can say iron undergone oxidation. Iron undergone oxidation. If you see in terms of water, second reactant. In this, hydrogen is with certain number of oxygen atoms before the reaction. But what happened after the reaction? It lost its oxygens. This loss of oxygens is known as reduction. We can say water is undergone reduction. We can say simply water is reduced. Iron is oxidized. Water is reduced. How we are telling this? In terms of oxygens. Iron initially in the free form, when it is combined with water, it is gaining certain oxygen atoms. This gaining of oxygen atoms is oxidation. Water initially is with a certain number of oxygen atoms in it. But after the reaction, it lost those oxygen atoms. So, this we can say as reduction. Here oxidation is going on, here reduction is going on. Now, in terms of oxidizing agent and reducing agent, if you say, the substance which is helping for the reduction of others, is called reducing agent. The substance which is helping for the oxidation of others is called oxidizing agent. To say simply, the substance which is getting oxidation is reducing agent. The substance which is getting reduction is a oxidizing agent. Let us see here. Iron is taking this oxygen from water and helping for the reduction of this water. What we can say now, iron? Iron is reducing agent. The one which is getting oxidation is reducing agent because it is taking oxygen from others and helping for the reduction of others. So the reduction helper is called reducing agent. Reducing helper, reducing agent. Iron is reducing agent. If you see in terms of water, water giving its oxygen to iron and it is helping for the oxidation of iron. So water is a oxidation helper, which is also called oxidizing agent. Water is oxidizing agent. The one which is getting reduction is oxidizing agent. The one which is getting oxidation, that is reducing agent. Quite opposite they will be. So here, now let us see the statements what they have given. They are given, iron metal is getting oxidized. Yes, iron is getting oxidized. This is a correct statement because iron is gaining certain number of oxygen atoms after the reaction. This is correct. Next one, water is getting reduced. Yes, water losing its oxygen, so it is getting reduced. That is also correct statement. Water is acting as reducing agent. Is it? No. Because water is acting as oxidizing agent. Because this water is giving oxygen atoms to iron and hence iron is getting oxidized. So water is helping for the oxidation of iron. Water is called now helper of oxidation or oxidizing helper, which is also called oxidizing agent. Water is oxidizing agent, not reducing agent. Now these three are correct and the third option is not correct. What will be correct answer? 1, 2, 4 are correct. Yes, C is correct answer. Very good. Nice. Let us see the next one. Oxidation is a process which involves addition of oxygen, addition of hydrogen, removal of oxygen, removal of hydrogen. Yes, you have to be careful in answering this question. Check carefully the options or statements given. About oxidation, they are asking. Yes, addition of oxygen or removal of oxygen. Or addition of hydrogen or removal of hydrogen. So in terms of oxygen, if it is explained oxidation, addition of oxygen is called oxidation. If we explain in terms of hydrogen, removal of hydrogens is called oxidation. So you may get here more than one correct options in this question. So observe carefully, answer those options which are there more than one. We can say addition of oxygen is oxidation. So A is correct answer. One more option we may get among these three. That is, yes, yeah, you are correct. There is removal of hydrogen is also called oxidation. These two are correct options for this. Good. Let's go to next question. That is, give the ratio in which hydrogen and oxygen are present in water by volume. So in which ratio hydrogen and oxygen combined in the formation of water, they are asking by volume. So we know the molecular formula of water. So based upon that, we can give its volumetric composition by the formation of the hydrogen and oxygen combination. Let us see options given. Is it 1:2? Is it 1:1? 2:1? 1:8? So which is correct ratio for hydrogen and oxygen in the formation of water by volume? If you remember once the if you recollect once the formula of water, we can say easily this. Check your answer. You can give your option in the chart. Yes, it is 2:1, because if you see the molecular formula or the composition of water, there are two hydrogen atoms combined with one oxygen. For each one volume of oxygen, two volumes of hydrogen are combining. So the volume ratio is 2:1. 2:1 ratio. That is correct. Next, let us go to next question. That is, they have given an equation here. Identify the substance oxidized in the above equation. So how can you find the substance which is oxidized? So for that, we can say in terms of oxygens, we can say simply here, or in terms of electrons also we can say. First, let us go through this manganese dioxide in terms of oxidation number. What is the oxidation number of manganese in this manganese dioxide? In the previous class, we have studied how to calculate the oxidation number of an element in a compound. We know the oxidation number of oxygen is -2. What does it mean by oxidation number? Yes, it is the charge possessed by an element in a molecule is its oxidation number. If you see, in the oxygen always in its oxides, it will show -2 charge. So the oxidation number of oxygen is -2. Whereas for the manganese, if you try to calculate the total oxidation numbers in a molecule is equal to charge present on that molecule. In this molecule, as there is no charge, so the total oxidation numbers in this molecule will be equal to 0. Suppose if you consider the oxidation number of manganese as X plus the oxidation number of each oxygen is -2. How many oxygen atoms are there? 2 oxygen atoms are there. So 2 into -2. So X plus 2 into -2 is equal to 0. That is charge present on the molecule 0. So if you simplify this, we get X value as, what do we get? +4. The oxidation number of manganese in this molecule is +4. If you see after the reaction, in this, we know chlorine will exhibit always -1 oxygen state in its molecules. So here, for chlorine it is -2. What will be for the manganese? Let us calculate that also here. For manganese, if you consider it is X and there are 2 chlorine atoms, 2 into for each chlorine oxidation number is -1. Total it is equal to charge present on the molecule 0. So 2 plus 2 into -1 is equal to 0. From this, we can calculate X value by simplification. X is equal to, what do we get? +2. Now, what happened to the oxidation number of manganese? If you observe from there to here, oxidation number is decreased from +4 to +2. The decrease in the oxidation number is called reduction. We can say it is reduced. Reduction. Manganese dioxide is reduced to manganese chloride. We can say that. Because reduction in the decrease in the oxidation number is called reduction. If you see for hydrogen here, or for chlorine, if you see for chlorine in this reaction, because always hydrogen will show plus 1 in the oxidation number. We see for chlorine here, for hydrogen it is plus 1 and for chlorine it is minus 1 here, because if you calculate you will get minus 1. And if you observe in this, for chlorine in the elementary form, always the oxidation number will be 0 for any element. In the elementary form, for any element, oxidation number is equal to 0, because there is no charge position. So it is equal to 0. What happened? The oxidation number of chlorine is increased from minus 1 to 0. Changing from minus 1 to 0, we can say it is increased. Increase in the oxidation number we can say as oxidation. So HCl undergone oxidation. HCl is oxidized, MnO2 is reduced. So now what we can say, this MnO2 is a oxidizing agent, because the one which is getting a reduction is a oxidizing agent. MnO2 is oxidizing agent, whereas HCl is, as it is getting rid of oxidation, it is called reducing agent. Now let us go to the options. What the question here? The substance oxidized, they are asking. Which is oxidized here? HCl. Because in this, the chlorine oxidation number changed from minus 1 to 0. Oxidation number is increased. So it is oxidized. The same we can say in terms of oxygens also. If you see, manganese dioxide initially is with oxygens. But after the reaction, what happened? It lost its oxygens. So we can say in this form also it is reduced. Loss of oxygen is called reduction. MnO2 is reduced. If you see HCl, hydrogen is initially with no oxygen, but after the reaction hydrogen gained certain number of oxygen. So gain of oxygen is also called oxidation. HCl is oxidized. Now correct answer is HCl. HCl is oxidized here. Now, let us go to next question. What type of chemical reactions takes place when electricity is passed through water? Yes, when water is undergone passing electricity, electricity is passed into water, what happens? Will it undergo displacement reaction or combination or decomposition or double displacement? What happens, children? If electricity is passed through water, we know electrolysis occurs. We know what is meant by electrolysis. Electro, electricity passage. Lysis, splitting. Splitting of water in the presence of electricity is called electrolysis. So, water splits into respective elements. So, the splitting of a compound into simpler substances is called, what it is? Good. It is called decomposition. It is also called here electrolysis. We might have seen in the lower classes, when electricity is passed through water, then water will split into respective gases. Hydrogen and oxygen will be emitted out. And these, we can see these bubbles. At one electrode, hydrogen will be emitted. At the other electrode, oxygen will be emitted. So this process is called electrolysis. Anyhow, here water splitting into respective elements, that is called decomposition. That's correct. Next, let us go to next question. Pb plus copper chloride. Lead plus copper chloride gives lead chloride plus copper. So what kind of reaction is this? The above reaction is an example of combination, double displacement, decomposition and displacement. You can see clearly here what kind of reaction is this, student. Here in copper chloride, copper is in combination with chlorine, but after the reaction with lead, what happened? Lead chloride formed. What you can say from this? Copper is replaced with replaced by lead. Lead is being more reactive than copper. It is displacing copper from its compound. So, copper is emitted out. This type of reactions we call? Yes. You can give your answer in the chat. Yes, it is correct. It is displacement reaction. Lead displacing here copper. More reactive element lead displacing less reactive element copper from its compound. These kind of reactions are called displacement reactions. It is displacement. Yes, correct it is. Next, let us go to one more question. Which of the following are exothermic processes? What does it mean by exothermic? The chemical reactions in which energy is omitted while the formation of products are called exothermic reactions. Let us say are given options. Reaction of water with quicklime, dilution of an acid, evaporation of water, sublimation of camphor. So these are the statements given. Out of these, which can emit energy while occurring this? Those come under exothermic reactions. If you see the first one, reaction of water with quicklime. Quicklime in the sense calcium oxide, whitewash powder it is actually. So when you add certain water to this quicklime or calcium oxide, if you touch the container after adding water, that becomes hot. This is because this addition of water to lime water emits certain amount of energy out. So we can say this is exothermic. Addition of water to quicklime is an exothermic reaction. Dilution of an acid. What does it mean by dilution? Addition of water to certain solutions is called dilution. So for acid, if you add water, that is called dilution of acid. Generally, the dilution of acids occurs by taking large quantity of water to that this acid will be slowly added by stirring continuously. So then that also emits certain amount of energy out. Dilution of acids also releases energy out. So these also will come under exothermic reactions. Next one, evaporation of water. This evaporation of water requires certain amount of energy. Means this water while evaporating takes certain amount of energy from our surroundings. So the reactions which takes energy are called as endothermic reactions, not exothermic. So this comes under endothermic. Endothermic reaction, not exothermic reaction. Because of this reason, evaporation takes energy from the surroundings. When evaporation occurs, the surroundings becomes a little cool because energy is taken by this water while evaporating. So this is endothermic reaction. Even sublimation also. What does it mean by sublimation? Converting solid directly into gaseous state, we know. So camphor, while converting from gaseous state to solid state to gaseous state, it should be heated. Means energy, heat energy should be given to that. So energy is taken. The reactions in which energy is taken are called endothermic reactions. So this also won't come under exothermic. So this also will go under endothermic reactions. Right. What will be correct answers? First and second only. Next one. Identify the correct statements in reaction to the following reaction. Okay. Now they are asking to identify the correct statements for this. Let us see. Zinc is acting as reducing agent. Hydrogen chloride is acting as oxidizing agent. Hydrogen chloride is oxidized. Zinc is acting as oxidizing agent. Let us see in terms of oxidation number. What is the oxidation number of zinc here? In the elementary form for any element, oxidation number is 0. But if you see in this, the combined with the chlorine, for each chlorine it is -1. If we calculate zinc, it will be +2. And if you see here, for chlorine, it is -1 as we told. And for hydrogen, it is +1 because it is -1. To neutralize, it will be +1. Now, if you observe oxidation numbers for zinc from 0 to +2, means it is increased, oxidation number is increased. So the increase in the oxidation number is called oxidation. If you see for hydrogen here, it is in the elementary form, it became 0. It is from plus 1 to 0, it is called reduction. Decrease in the oxidation number is called reduction. Now you can say zinc is oxidized, HCl is reduced. And the one which is getting oxidation is a reducing agent. Means zinc is reducing agent. And HCl is a oxidizing agent because it is getting reduction. Now let us go to the options. Zinc is acting as reducing agent. It is correct. Hydrogen chloride is acting as oxidizing agent. Yes, it is also correct. Hydrogen chloride is oxidized. Hydrogen chloride is oxidized. No, hydrogen chloride is reduced. It is not correct. Zinc is acting as oxidizing agent. It is also not correct. Now, what will be correct answers? Zinc is a reducing agent. It is correct. Hydrogen chloride acting as oxidizing agent. This is also correct. So these two are correct now. This is wrong. So these two are the correct statements. Zinc is acting as oxidizing agent. Hydrogen chloride is acting as oxidizing agent. Yes, children? Yeah, these two are the correct statements. Okay. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates. Thank you.